Well, he's best known for being part of the Chaser team and pushing the boundaries of comedy. Let's welcome Julian Morrow to Studio 10.
That's a great way to come in.
Julian.
I love that.
Hello, how are you? Good to see you.
We're expecting you to do something crazy.
Oh, I like the entrance, yeah. I feel like the Price is Right.
Hey, come on down.
Let's talk a little bit about your background. You went from working in hotels to being the funny guy.
From being a porter in hotels to the ABC, my career's been a downward trajectory. But when I was at uni, I used to work at the Sheraton carrying bags, and it was great. Met lots of interesting people, the West Indies cricket team in the 90s, so my lips are sealed. But they had a good time. And, met people like Alan Bond and things like that. And now, you know, just make jokes and occasionally get in a bit of trouble.
Didn't you spill something in Alan Bond's bag?
Yeah, I did. Alan Bond, years ago, he had that trial where he was claiming that he'd lost his memory. He was a long-term customer at the Sheraton, and he was given an upgrade. And so I had to do the upgrade. He didn't know he was getting an upgrade, so everything in the room was unpacked. So I had to pick up his undies and all this sort of stuff from all over the place. Just a little bit unpleasant. And it turned out that he had a whole lot of, like, you know, plaques, that mouth stuff, in a white bag, which I spilt everywhere, including all over his medication. So I like to think that Bondi lost a few IQ points because of me. Yeah.
Now, you've actually paired up... Well, sorry.
What brings you here?
Well, what does bring me here? Funnily enough.
What brings you here,
yes,
Jules?
Yes, yeah, yeah.
Kristina does.
Yeah. That's right, that is right. I have a long history of making things embarrassing for people who've been involved in politics. And now...
this is the ultimate?
A new spin on that, because Kristina and I are starting a new live event a little bar that me and the other Chaser guys run in Sydney. It's called Photo Op, and we are interviewing politicians and former politicians about their lives and careers by using embarrassing photographs, which has been great, because it meant that I got to have a look at some of Kristina's embarrassing photographs.
Yes, we have seen, yes.
There's some great ones there. Oh, look at that. That's a lovely moment. Very graceful under pressure.
What happened there?
Because that is everyone's worst nightmare.
That's right.
And you're falling over in public.
And yeah, I was going to do an interview on health reform. Whatever I said on health reform, nobody remembers. But if you Google me, this photo comes up right at the top.
Yes. It's a bit like Usain Bolt about to sort of take off.
Oh, look at that. Sweet. Isn't that lovely? You'll that's get, me getting my first communion.
Yeah. I was going to say, it's just before I went to ICAC. That's right. As a witness.
so let me get this straight, Kristina. You receive an email saying the Chaser would like to do a Q&A with you involving embarrassing photos. You think, what could possibly go wrong?
Actually, what I said is, how about I help you do the Q&A on other politicians?
That's right, adding a bit of credibility, as always. So this week we've got Tony Windsor, the former independent MP from New England. Oh, look at that.
I
don't think that's Kristina.
This is not me. Any embarrassing photos, Tony Windsor? He seems so sensitive.
Well, some of them, this is lovely with his ute.
And he's a dreamboat.
He was quite a fetching. Yeah, that is what I thought when I saw that photo. What a fetching young man. Mm.
That's not embarrassing at all.
No,
the
great thing about this is the classic bush photograph for a politician. Tony says he can't even remember what's going on in this photo. And you do wonder. They seem to just be pointing to dirt.
It's dry, mate. It's dry.
I believe that, legally speaking, he should be wearing a chambray shirt and moleskins.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Have you rocked in a Kubra in your time?
I have rocked in a Kubra in my time. Know if we have a photo of it.
Yes.
But you do feel very odd as a city politician because, you're out there in a tucked-in shirt and a Kubra, and you think, I would never wear this in the middle of Sydney. I don't know I'm assuming many people, including our own Jono, probably have some embarrassing photos in their collection.
Let's have a look at some
Jono
of those.
Jono would not have any.
That's from a private
18 and legal, I don't believe it.
he looks like he could be breastfeeding.
These are from a private collection.
I think we're going to have to get Jono along to photo opportunity.
Absolutely.
What do you think?
These are from a private collection. You will be hearing from my lawyers.
We're still trying to track down a photo of Jono with his shirt on.
He loves getting his gear off. He loves it.
Well, we don't want photos of Jono, but we would love photos of Tony Windsor.
That's right.
Well, Photo Opportunity premieres this Thursday night. To get your tickets, head to giantdwarf.com.au/ Studio 10. There's a special discount for Studio 10 viewers.
Hello.
And if you want to send photos for the night, you can email them to photo.op@giantdwarf.com.au. Thanks again, Julian, for coming in.
Thanks for being here. Excellent.